Scottish Screen was set up to help develop and fund filmmakers who are based in Scotland. Filmmakers in Aberdeen, however, have been left feeling neglected by the funding that Scottish Screen has to offer.
I think geographically it's 90% based in Glasgow. I think the system should be each area is allocated a certain amount of funding every year, right? Spread it out a bit.
You know, I've dealt with British Screen, Scottish Screen, but you know, we have to be realistic as to the fact that there's hundreds and thousands of filmmakers in Britain or wannabe filmmakers applying to these people for money and sort of using their schemes. So it's became very difficult. And for, you know, Scottish Screen, they're based in Glasgow. Aberdeen, for a lot of years, hasn't had a sort of an independent council to deal with Aberdeen-based filmmakers. So it's difficult, you know.
They are Glasgow and centrally belt orientated. And I think that a lot of people in Grampian have been put off applying for funding because the funding process takes so long. And I know for a fact that only 3 people applied for funding from Grampian last year. 39 people from Glasgow applied. And I think that a lot of people in Grampian, myself included, actually thought that Scottish Screen didn't think about Grampian as being a talented area. But I think I have to educate the people in this area that put your application form in. Saturate Scottish Screen so that somebody from Grampian will have a chance of getting funding.
I mean, Scottish Screen will give £60,000 to a filmmaker to make one short film. It's gone, right? Poof, that film doesn't make any money, that guy's fucked. What they should do is spend 10 grand and buy people non-linear editing systems and a camera. Because if you can't make the film yourself, then what the fuck do you deserve the money for, right? So they could fund far more people, give them just a nice little system to start out with. You know, it would cost them less. So, you know, figure out who's actually got the goods and who's full of shit before you chuck £100,000 at them.
There are now more Aberdeen-based filmmakers than ever, and the Film Office is now in its second year. So, is it now possible for Aberdeen to have a film industry in the foreseeable future?
It's a very romantic ideal, you know, but if you look at the practicalities, if you crunch the numbers and look at the funding we'd need, it's a bit like saying, you know, could we build an Olympic stadium? You know, of course we couldn't build an Olympic stadium. It would take a massive amount of European funding, city council funding, you know, lottery funding. Who's going to organise that?
I don't have confidence that we will ever have a film industry in Aberdeen. I don't think we can compete to have a film industry. An industry is too big a word to use. First of all, we're not a big enough city to attract moneyed people to put money into the film unless we can tap the private sector.
Aberdeen at the moment doesn't have anything to offer filmmakers except the city, the way it looks, maybe.
It can only get better, it can't get much worse because it's horrendous just now. There's nothing for the young guys coming into this industry. You've got to think about realistic targets and jobs. Right now in Aberdeen, there's absolutely no prospects for any filmmaker. And that's just the way it is, that is fact.
All we can really do is film as best we can up here and show the products as widely as we can, providing they're good, you know? I think the worst thing we can have is a bunch of twats turning up with a camcorder sort of thing. You know, amateur productions, you know, when they get publicised, we all look shite.
The advice I would give people who want to make a low-budget film in Aberdeen is think before you start. It's all very well having a great script and great ideas, that's the first stage, but unless you know where you're going to go to get funding, don't start it.
Don't overreach, don't get arrogant, because we did that as well. Because the first time I started to make films, I was like, right, we're going to reinvent the wheel, and off we went, and we fell flat on our arses, because we went too big, you know, too soon.
Keep your crew tight. And choose your crew, select your crew properly. I mean, take your time selecting your crew because at the end of the day, they're going to have to stick with you from the beginning to the end of this project, which might take 6 months or however long it takes. So,
the main skills a director needs to have, if you've got no money, is you need to know how to do it quickly and how to do it cheaply.
And you've also got to not mind going and asking people for money because sometimes I think people can get embarrassed. You know, and we're well past the embarrassment. We're just, where's the fucking money?
Just to get out there and do it, you know. There's a lot of young filmmakers like to talk about what they're going to do with this and, you know, they're going to be the next thing to make this movie and that movie. Until they actually put things into motion, then it's all talk, isn't it, you know? I mean, you can write as much screenplays as you want until you're blue in the face. If you want to do that, then you're a writer, you know. If you want to be a filmmaker, then you've got to get out there with your crew and your camera and go and make what you've written. You know, there's two types of people in this industry. There's film spectators and there's filmmakers. And you can either be one of the two, you know.
The filmmaking process can be long and frustrating, and many low-budget directors find it difficult to keep going.
The advice I'd give to people who are trying to make movies in Aberdeen who are wanting to give up is obviously don't give up. If they felt so that passionate about movies and that, it probably wouldn't cross their mind. They would do it anyway.
Comes a bit much now and again, you know. And I mean, filmmaking without a doubt is a very difficult industry to make it in. So I think you've got to keep going. I mean, if you're doing it for the love of what you do, then you'll always keep going. I mean, if you're doing it to make a quick buck, then you know, you're gonna come across problems, because it's never gonna be that easy to make quick money out of filmmaking, you know.
Here's the point, right? Why do you go and get funding, you know, when you can do it yourself, right? So people who've been denied funding are increasingly going down the route of saying, right, I'll just set up my own digital facility.
I couldn't hand on heart say to any filmmaker, stick around, you never know what might happen. We may get funding on board and I may be able to fund your next film. You know, and realistically, if the film office is only run from year to year on a part-time basis, there's no money for funding, you know, someone's profession, if you like.
I mean, I've spent a lot of years here in Aberdeen trying to create films here and try to project a sort of positive image with Aberdeen, and you know, it's now at the stage where if it's not happening, and you know, you've been banging your head off a brick wall for so long, what can you do? You know, you gotta change the way people think. So I mean, I've now got to think, well, am I going to continue to do this, or am I going to go where opportunities lie? And you know, you're going to get a bit more sort of creative freedom.
No one ever talks out. I don't give a shite about talking out, because I'll just do it myself anyway. I've got, you know, nothing to lose particularly. And I think if no one ever talks out, then nothing ever changes, right? And so I'm going to stir the shit a bit.
The lack of help does frustrate you. I mean, and sometimes you probably do want to give up, because I mean, there's no point, but the way I see it, it's going to get done regardless. If someone wants to give me money, I'm going to take it. If someone wants to help me, I'm going to take it. If they don't, I'm still going to do it.
Somebody's after me. I can't pretend to be something I know I'm not. I'm when they come for me. Just let them be, 'cause all that I need today is all I need. I just don't wanna be thinking thoughts that I think, dreaming my dreams, I'm drifting within. I don't know where I'm going, but I know where I've been. Come on, look within. Someone will always be more than I'll ever be, so then I'll be myself. And when they come for me, I'll just let them be, 'cause all that I need today, I need today. I just don't wanna be thinking thoughts that I think, dreaming my dreams, I'm drifting within. I don't know where.